question number 20 now. And again, this is maybe helpful because we are actually given some graphs. So remember on the test, you can, if you get stuck on something, you can move on to the next one and maybe it'll give you a picture of a graph that will jog your memory. And so these are tangent, secant, tangent, cosecant, cotangent, secant. Now this is where I remember that tangent, it goes up from left to right. It's increasing that way because remember, at zero, sine is zero, cosine is one, and sine starts getting larger, cosine starts getting smaller. So you've got a fraction that's increasing. It's getting bigger and bigger, where the sine, as the sine gets bigger, until, and the cosine is getting smaller, which is in the denominator, and as it gets closer to zero, go there. So, and again, I highly recommend having a graphing calculator than these. Just graph each of these and you'll be able to compare. But this one here is definitely the tangent. It goes from left to right, it's increasing, and it's got kind of this S-curve. The cotangent looks very similar, but it goes the other direction. It comes down, and so it's decreasing from left to right. You just have to kind of remember those. So this one is your standard tangent equation. And again, it's just something that you need to know from having done the graphs review, okay? So we're going to skip this one. We're going to come to the next one, which is very similar. But notice what's happening here. It's at 0, 0. It's not there. It's been shifted a little bit to the left. How much? Well, that's half of a pi and a half. So that's a pi over 4. It's been shifted pi to the fourth, pi over 4 to the left. If you remember from algebra, that's a translation. And it's a horizontal translation to the left. That happens when you actually are adding something inside to the x. So it moves sort of opposite and not into the positive direction, it moved into the negative direction. So that's gotta be, and again, I can just see it's a tangent function and it's the only other tangent function. And it's not the standard one that starts at 0, 0. Okay, so it's been shifted. So that one, definitely a tangent. Because of its direction, it's going upwards here, and then so this one, these U-shaped up and U-shaped down, sort of parabola type looking things. They're not really parabolas, but it kind of looks like it. So what I have to do is, this is either going to be a secant or it's going to be a cosecant, and we have both to choose from. So we've got a secant here, a secant there, and a cosecant there. So since there's two secants, I'll bet you it's probably a secant, but let's see if we can figure it out. First of all, where is it undefined? Well, it's undefined at pi over 2. So that means, remember, at pi over 2, what's 0 at pi over 2, sine or cosine? Let's take a look. Not that one. Where is, let's close that one. My formula sheet. Cosine is 1 at 0. Cosine is 0 at pi over 2. So at pi over 2, cosine is 0. That's got to be, so that means cosine is in the denominator. That's got to be a secant. Okay. And notice it starts at 2. So remember, in here you could draw in the cosine function, so it's got an amplitude of 2, so either one of these is coming in. And now the question is about period. Remember, is it x over 2 or is it x? If it was x over 2, so all these things we got to ask again, just graph it and you'll see it. This would be, so we're going to think it's going to affect the period, right? And again, I'll just, so we got, if it was, so I'm just trying to consider, is it y equals 2 secant x over 2, or is it y equals 2 secant x? Well, this x over 2 is really, what this is telling us is that the b, remember, you have a is amplitude, I'll do this cosine of bx, b is your, gives you your period, and it tells you that 2 pi over b is your period. So if b is equal to 1/2, that would mean that we have 2 pi over 1/2, reciprocate and multiply, so that gives us 2 pi divided by 1/2, flip it and multiply, so that's 2 times 2. That would mean it would be 4 pi. So that means, and look at this, we go from, usually the standard one would be 2 pi, right? So we go from here, here, this is one period of secant, like in the cosine curve, and it goes from, let's see, I guess we could go from here to here, so that's 0 to 8 pi over 4, which is 2 pi. It's got the standard cosine, the period. The period has not been changed. It's not 4 pi. So if this one was it, it means that it would have been stretched out. So if it's not this one, it's just the standard secant of x. Okay. And again, the best way to do any of these, if they're on the test, is to just graph them each and then kind of set your windows by here. But it's just, remember, this is kind of how I did the on the unit circle. We're just counting by pi's, 3 pi over 4, 4 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, 6 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4, 8 pi over 4, that's 2 pi. Okay, so we're going from 0 to 2 pi is a period, right? We go from this and then we start repeating. Okay, hopefully that's helpful. Some of these with the graphs, it just, you just have to get experience with doing the graph. All right, that's 20.